Hey, what's going on? I had a wonderful opportunity today to talk with Lana Williams of 3LW TV, YouTube sensation. Ring a bell? If not, let's check out this clip. So if you have a moment, come on, let's listen to what Lonel has to say.
It is actually 3L, which three L's for my blog. Before I started doing videos, I actually had a blog called Living and Loving Life with Lonel Williams. So 3 L's, Living and Loving Life, and then LW being my initials. So it's kind of a play on words. And then at the time, 3LW, which is what I wanted to call the show, was actually owned by a record company because there was a singing group with that same name. So they still had the rights to that name. So I added the TV on at the end. So that's 3LW TV. I originally just started doing with a lot of my travel videos, and people wanted to share the pictures. I just started doing photographs, and people would ask if they could share them. I was like, sure. So then the email list, it just grew to be too much, so I started doing a blog. And then from that, it just grew into videos. And I said, actually, the reason I did the very first video, was when I met B. Scott. He and I had dinner and in LA, and we hit it off immediately. And so after dinner, we went to Starbucks because we were like blah, 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 blah. And then I did like a little impromptu video just like this. I was holding the camera up in his face and he answered a couple of questions. Well, he posted it on his site, got a lot of hits, and I posted it on my blog at the time, and so many people liked it. And I said, you know, I do have a little production know-how, so maybe I'll do something with this. But if I do it, it has to have a purpose. It has to mean something. I'm not just going to stand in front of the camera acting like a hot ratchet mess. No shade to those that do, but that's just not who I am. So I did that, and then I decided, well, what's missing? What's missing is we don't have images of ourselves, enough positive images, or enough diverse images of our community. So why don't we empower ourselves? And that's kind of how it was all born. I got tired of people saying all the time that they were bored, that they were horny, and that they wanted to smoke. 24/7, come on. There's so much more. I knew that there was more than that in the world that I lived in and that I saw, and I just wanted to share that. And so I reached out to people that I knew initially, and it just kind of grew from there. So it's okay to be bored, horny, and you don't want to smoke, but not 24/7, because we are so much more than that. And that's really what I set out to do. And that's really what Standing in Your Light was all about, just being your authentic self. Because I just saw so much as I traveled the world, just how beautiful we are. And I just really wanted to share that. So that's what Stand in Your Light. And at first I was really apprehensive about using that. Like, that is so corny, Stand in Your Light. What kind of esoteric spiritual crap is that? And then one day I was like, you are corny, boo. So that's who I am. And that's what I do. And that's where Stand in Your Light came from. Because I was trying to sell this concept to the guests, and you know, you want to tell people, come up to my room, get in bed, we're going to have an interview during a Sizzle Miami. They really think you have ulterior motives. So it was like, no, no, no. So I finally got one guy who did it. Well, when he showed up, his friends brought him because he was, you know, nervous or whatever. And so I went downstairs at the hotel to get him. I'm standing out in my Chinese silk pajamas, and it's 100 degrees in Miami. But they pull up, and they're like, what in the world? So anyway, I invited his friends up. I was like, you all can come up and, you know, watch, and so that he would feel more comfortable. Well, he came up, and what happened was that all of them ended up in the bed. So we ended up having five of us all together in the bed. And it turned out to be a lot of fun. And then after that, because I shoot them back to back in the same day, and then the other guests just started flowing, because then they started talking about how much fun they had, and the other people started going, then everybody just started asking. So it was never really awkward beyond that very first encounter, trying to sell it to somebody, trying to sell a concept that they don't know. They know who I am, sort of, but you know, you're talking, you inviting them to come to your hotel room and get in bed for an interview. It was, yeah, that was a little awkward, but I keep it on the up and up. I'm professional. So that was all. It was good. Oh yeah, I always plan to have a presence on YouTube. That's where I started, with the whole social media. And even as the multiple social media platforms arise, I still plan to keep YouTube. As long as it's a viable option and my audience is there, wherever they are, I will be there to meet them. So yeah, I do plan to continue to use YouTube, and Twitter have been the two that have been the most instrumental in changing my life, clearly. But as the new ones come up, I always establish an account on the new different platforms, but I'll still be on YouTube. I ain't gonna know where am I gonna go. I mean, I might not be doing it with as much frequency as you would like, but that's just because there's just so much going on. But it is my plan to stay wherever the audience is, and wherever I can connect with them, that's where I will be. So as long as that I'm here and able and I have a voice, the gay community will be a part of that. Now, what I'm thrilled about is that I'm seeing there are a lot more people expressing their voices as well. So I don't feel like I'm one of the very few that's carrying the entire burden, if you will. But there's so many of us now that are doing so much. So I'm glad to see that. So that tells me that what I've started, along with some others who initiated this for our community, it's working and it's having a wonderful effect, but I'll never abandon the integrity of what I started, so I'll still be here. I ain't going nowhere.